Dear Moderator, Martinella Petrova, dear Vice Prime Minister, dear Minister Pavlova, dear Ministers, State Secretaries, Honourable Members of the European Parliament, dear colleagues from several institutions, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, many thanks to the Bulgarian government and presidency. I think this conference is a turning point in our common preparatory process of the next MFF. Thanks its timely planning, just halfway between our kickoff conference in Brussels and 2nd of May. Next week, the Parliament is discussing and bringing two reports. So I think for the moment we are on track. Let me use this high-level conference for to be quite concrete and to send out some messages and send out some questions from our side. The Commission has to fulfill their function, which is in the treaty. But we are mainly a service provider. Our interest is to have a balanced proposal, which is not fully acceptable, but quite acceptable as a starting point for all of you. I've been in Zagreb yesterday. I've been in, meanwhile, 20 member states. I've been in all democratic groups of the parliament. I met many national parliaments. I could read a lot from think tanks, from academic institutions. So I know nearly all positions, and all are acceptable. But it's about unanimity. You, as ministers, you need a majority. Sometimes it's easy, sometimes it's quite difficult. Seeing the new government in Germany after 6 months, seeing Italy, whatever will happen. So you have a lot of experience. But did you ever need unanimity? The whole opposition, sorry. Never ever. So all of us, all, Commission, Council, net payers, new member state, founding members, members of parliament, we have to be flexible. Nothing can be a Bible. Nothing, sorry. Because the worst case would be to have no MFF or an old-fashioned MFF, not future-proof. The winner would be autocrats in Ankara and Moscow and traitors in DC. This can't be our interest. The Bratislava process, the Rome process, can be filled by all of you, by all of us. If we are taking the MFF as our priority from now on, and your presence is motivating me, high-level people from all member states, rapporteurs from the parliament, committee presidents of the parliament, court of auditors, committee of regions, all European institutions. Normally, you should say, let's stay in Sofia. Let's stay over weekend or up to Easter, not to leave Sofia before we have a decision. And to surprise our heads of state and government, and my president, would be a pleasure for me. It's not realistic. But I think we need a tough approach, an approach as a team in a European collegiality. First point, we have to speak about new responsibilities. Let me turn the agenda. What is new? What was not on our agenda in 2011, 12, 13? There are times migration, the refugee crisis, Islamistic developments, failed states in Africa, civil war in Syria. All this was not really so relevant as it is meanwhile, and it will be an ongoing issue, even an increasing issue. Do you really think that one member state can it solve better than our union? I don't think so. Not Malta, not Germany. Together we are strong. The refugee crisis, more development aid. humanitarian aid. We have to speak about refugees 20, 25. They all are born. And if we don't stabilize their humanitarian situation, security, water, food, education, a perspective, then they will come. May it be via Italy, may it be via Greece, they will come to us. So to invest is more efficient. But to invest via a European budget, via a coherent strategy. Defense, same thing. America first means Europe second, or third, or nothing. It's about our external and internal security. And we can bring the proof to invest on a European level, to organize standards, to organize tenders. It's much more efficient. It's in the interest of our taxpayers, our European taxpayers, our German, Dutch, French, Austrian taxpayers. Take research in a digital age. We are speaking about 3% of our GDP investment in R&D. The more we speak, we never reach. Less than 2%. 3% in EU28 would mean 450 billion euro. We are investing less than 300. We have a gap of 150. We have Sunday speeches. And Horizon has 12 billion, not bad. 12 of 450. I think there is added value to invest. At least 12, no, more. To finance joint undertakings, to realize digital projects, and so on. So, which new responsibilities you see? We are sending you a menu. You are our guest. We are cooking. We are delivering and serving. You have to order what you want to have. And then we can decide. So, new responsibilities, challenges, and added value. That's the first point. Let's speak all together about 10 billion, at least, for new responsibilities. Should we finance it totally by cuts? I don't think so. Because the battle, migration against cohesion, defense against CAP, could destroy this round table. Sorry, I'm frank. Could destroy this round table. So we need a balanced compromise with cuts and with some additional money. I'm convinced. We have to see how to modernize our programs. And our consultation process now has come to an end. Yesterday, I think. We are analyzing, we are thankful, we got a lot of advice. Of course, we can better. How to modernize, how to simplify our rules, how to come to a high level of flexibility. All of these intentions we see and we will integrate in our MFF proposal. Being here in Sofia, speaking about cohesion, let me be quite clear. Our GDP per capita in Europe average is about 28,000 euro. That's EU 27. Germany about 40,000 euro. Luxembourg 100,000 euro. Bulgaria 6,500. We are here guests in a country with a GDP per capita of 6,500. Shouldn't we change this? Shouldn't we reduce the gap? As you are doing in your country between rural areas and your metropole, your capital and a small city. As I have been doing in Baden-Württemberg with financial support to our new lender, to the eastern part of Germany. I'm a European meanwhile. That's my problem, or your problem, sorry. I feel responsible for Stuttgart, but for Sofia and rural areas in Romania as well, in the same dimension. If this gap between 100,000 and 6,500, or Romania 7,400, can't be reduced, our union will be not united. Maybe will destroy it. Not by bringing Luxembourg down, but by bringing our new member states from 6,000 to 10 to 12 to 14 to 20. And at the end of the day, Bulgaria, Romania, Croatia, having a higher GDP is good for all of our industries in a single market. Having stronger consumer, better infrastructure, more research here. It's a long-term strategy, but we have not an annual budget. We have a long-term MFF. MFF means thinking long-term, thinking up to 2030, now or never. We have to speak about the timing of next weeks and months. And here is my main concern. We are preparing the sixth edition of an MFF. The first one was Jacques Delors in 1988. But never ever we had such a problem we have now. MFF proposal coming out by the Commission, and the first year, January 2021, on the other hand, and in between, European election. What would be the usual procedure? As we did in 2011, 12, 13, because the Barroso Commission came out June 11. Afterwards, nothing happened. Nothing. Some roundtables, think tanks, parliament, up and down, blah, 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 nothing happened. Why the Commission has to come out now, as you are asking for? It's our legal order. We have to come out. Why? If you don't use our proposal immediately, intensively. If you say, we have no interest for the moment, I stay here, skiing, holidays, coming back autumn and continuing. We are working so hard these days. We are working really hard, hopefully in your interest, in our common interest, that you and heads of state and government and parliament are saying, this is our 2018-2019 priority. Because if we don't come forward, we have a huge problem. We have a campaign with responsible campaigners. All you are responsible, pragmatic, pro-European. But there are others saying we need much more money in the European budget for to realize the paradise. And others are saying, see, shit bureaucrats, no money to them. In between, in the sandwich, all of us. Wonderful. We have top candidates. Afterwards, a new parliament. My concern, 50% new members. 50%. From the left wing, from the right wing, with Macronists and no socialists, difficult. Difficult. Then they have to come to new structure. Posts and candidates, summer break. Then we have hearings, at least 20 new candidates for the Commission. In parallel, nothing will happen. I'm not sure will we have a new Commission 1st of November next year. I'm not sure. A next president. But we will have a next president of the European Council, of the Parliament, of the Commission, end of next year. And then we need a new start. Then we are on the same position as today, February 2020. And we come to a decision in 2020, December. And farmers need clarity and certainty. Researchers need clarity and certainty. Regions, mayors, all of our partners. Because 2014 and one semester in 15 have been totally lost years. To avoid this, not to repeat the same mistake, to learn from the past as a learning system, would mean to take the MFF as a priority. In council, in committees of parliament, via trilogues, negotiations, that's my wish. We are flexible. But to have no decision would be worst case for me. We can fill the Bratislava process by a constructive, offensive, debate. Now, and this would send out a perfect signal of good governance. UK leaving and 27 coming together in such, as I know, so difficult point. Please, let's do together our best for to avoid a worst case and for to demonstrate to our citizens before the election and to the whole world, Europe is alive and united.